Hey guys, it's Becky and welcome to my first ever sketchbook tour. So this is my sketchbook that I bring around everywhere I go. I took the sketchbook out with me between October 2021 till February 2022. This is a small 3.5 to 5.5 Stillman & Byrne Nova series in tone gray. So it has a cool undertone and this is what I've been using for the past 4 or so months. It's my first ever tone sketchbook, so I did have an exciting time just trying to sketch this in, especially with watercolor, and I had to bring in gouache actually just to bring out some of the highlights because the base of my sketchbook is already a mid-tone. First, I'm going to flip through really quick and then I will start to talk about each sketch. Alright, so that is a full flip through of my sketchbook. If you like this video and you want to see more of this stuff, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe and tell your friends as well. And now we're gonna look through each page. This is the first ever tone sketchbook I used, so I wanted to test out my materials. I tried out a white gouache and I tried a white signal pen, and I can see that with that, the highlights come out. This is pure watercolor. This is an art toolkit pocket palette with Holbein watercolors. If you want more information on my sketching materials, I've listed it down in the description, and I also posted a video about my most compact sketching materials. This is a gray tone sketchbook, and it says it's good for light washes. These pages are a little bit warped, I guess from some of the heavier washes. This was my first run at the test sketch. I tried to use Holbein Chinese white watercolor, which turns out to be really, really strong. It's almost like a titanium white, and I can see the colors really coming through. But also, I noticed that the colors come out really, really pastel. I'm not sure if it's because I've used white gouache, so the colors are cooler, or if it's because this sketchbook is a cool tone and therefore it's cooler, but I figured this is the limitations that I've been set up with, so I might as well go with it. This is my first on-location sketch, and this was just at a train station or a subway station, and these are whites that I tried to color in white. I was just waiting for a friend, so I just tried using all the colors. I tried sketching in stuff first. See, this is a bit more pastel than I like it to be. This is actually done during a press conference that I was listening to. So my day job is a reporter, and I get to go into a lot of these conferences, and I tried this out in low light just to see. It was really dark in there, so I wasn't able to put in color at all. So this was just a really, really, really quick sketch. This is done looking outside the window. This was, you know, me trying to do a little bit more wet and wet washes, and I just added turquoise into my palette, I remember, because I fell in love with the color. It was so beautiful. I just splashed it in. I really like how it looks on this page. It really does stand out. It's got a warm tone to it. I think it contrasts really beautifully with a cool tone. This is a key shop. So this key duplicate shop in San Shui Po, one of the neighborhoods in Hong Kong. I just tried to draw in all the intricate pieces. I don't think I got all of it right, but I tried to get the fan and the angles, and once in a while I do like a simple sketch without being bogged down by color, just to really get the form in. This is a fairy seed. I tried to color in with my Unisigno gel pen, but I wasn't really happy with how scratchy it is. Maybe it's because, so this is the pen I have. I can't really tell what the thickness of it is. I think I might have to look into Posca pens to get a little bit more solid color in. These are, I go on subways a lot, or in Hong Kong they call it the MTRs, and I really like to draw the people on it just because it's a really interesting way to capture the moment. And the mask honestly makes it really easy to draw people's faces now. I don't need to worry about the nose and the mouth because that always makes me feel really, really awkward. This was in a restaurant waiting for my friends to arrive. Oh, this is when I first got my Fude pen. So I was trying it out. I was testing out thick lines and trying out thin lines and varying widths. And I did this while waiting for the train to come. And there was a glass sort of window, the glass barrier between where we stand and where the trains are going to come. And so I just saw my reflection in that glass and I drew it. More people on the MTR. This is actually on the MTR to Disneyland. So you can see the Disney shape, but the train ride was only about 5 minutes. So this was all I could get in 5 minutes. Couldn't draw much of it. And this is me in the Disneyland MTR waiting for a friend. Oh, I think I used a tone pen for this. I use a tone gray for this. This was all using also a Fude pen, but with Noodler's Lexington gray. And this was Theatre Mantis Document Urban Sienna, which I realized I like the Urban Sienna a little bit more just because it stands out against the cool page, so I could get that, or gets a wider temperature range. This is a cart filled with empty bottles, empty containers in front of a local shop here in one of the Hong Kong areas called Chun Wan. This is a corner in a sushi roll shop and they have all these different kinds of snacks and I thought this corner was really cute, so I just wanted to draw it in. This is a rooftop where I go to run. I think this was quite a sunny day. It was quite a bright day, so I tried to draw in all the flowers. Another MTR shot, but this time it's a different kind of MTR. It's a newer MTR, actually. So the seats are newly made, and the structure's a little bit different, and I wanted to draw in all the geometrical straight lines, so I put that in. I wanted to try drawing without an outline, so this is what I ended up with. I have to say, I actually quite like it, but because the people are moving, so you could really tell that I added this person in afterwards, because you can see the red pole that was just there. This was again another talk that I attended. This was a restaurant. It's called 1441. I didn't have time to sketch in the 1441, but I really wanted to get this perspective of the restaurant itself. This is during a windy day, actually. I tried to draw in the motions of the plastic bags, but basically everything was flying around. All the umbrellas were shut. This is in a rooftop. I thought the windy scene was quite memorable and I wanted to capture that day this way. This was at a cafe, and this is actually glass where some of the sunshine came through but most of the light was blocked, so I tried just sketching straight with the paint. I had lunch here once. It's in a park, sat here near a pond, had a bento box with me, and after I finished I was really intrigued by these statues. So these are like dolphin statues that spout water out of them. I try to only put detail in one in the hopes that you can kind of infer it to the others, but maybe I should have put like a second degree of detail here and then none here and it would have been fine. These are smart toilets, age-friendly toilets that my friends developed, and they were at an exhibition, but I really had trouble getting all the form in because all of it was gray-white. Trying to differentiate the forms was really tough, but I think I'll give it another go when I see it next. This is a cute little corner across the street where I was meeting with a bunch of urban sketchers and I had a little bit of extra time. We were actually talking about warm and cool temperatures that day and I didn't really stick to the assignment because all of this was cool. I just thought it was a really cute corner. I could not get it in. These are more MTR sketches. There was a really, this exact shade of blue ad that was running across all the doors, so I thought I would just get this bit on my sketchbook. I got a little bit bored of my MTR sketches and just sketching people on the train because it's always the same view. I'm always doing it while I'm sitting down. So I just tried a different thing, try to do faces instead. Oh, this was a boy that I was seeing on the MTR and he was so engrossed on his phone and he was staying still and he was keeping that pose, so I drew him. These are objects that I found on the MTR or that people are holding on the MTR. I think this is a scarf, water bottle, shopping bags, bags with a phone and some hands on it, so that was squish on someone's lap. This is actually pretty cool. I should start doing this again. More MTR faces. This was a rooftop bar. As you can see, this is like the umbrella, and this is supposed to be the wall structure, but I didn't get to finish it because my friend arrived sooner than I expected. And this is at my friend's house, and we are playing this camel game. These are iconic Hong Kong taxis. I saw three of them were parked in a row and I was actually waiting for a bus to arrive. So I just took out my sketchbook and I thought I'd start painting these. And this is on the bus itself. These are like the cushions that cover Hong Kong's buses, or I guess are on Hong Kong's buses. It's always dark purple with these patterns on them, so I thought I'd catch it. This is a scene at my friend's place. This was waiting for my friends at a restaurant. This is a hot pot restaurant, so this was the menu with the QR code, the soup bowl, the glass, and this is actually my phone. This was a fruit market in Causeway Bay, so I just tried to draw all the different fruits, pictures on a blackboard, but I tried to get all the different colors in, and you can see that they're in baskets. And this is in, I guess, a street alleyway. This is just some cardboard boxes that are folded. And there are more cardboards here. I think these are flattened cardboards as well. And they're all tied together in this cart. And this is seats in a ferry. So shifting away from the NTRs and buses, but I'm still sticking to my public transport. This is a shisha slash hookah. This whole thing is clear. So I was really trying to figure out how to get the reflection on it. There's supposed to be water droplets around all these glasses, but I could get the tube that was inside and mask it a little bit. But this was really tricky. Drawing glass is really tricky. I try to get the reflection in as well because this is supposed to be metal. Shiny surfaces are always really tricky to draw. This was me in the office. It was after hours. Start drawing myself in through the reflection on the window. And this is inside a meeting room in my office. This, I'm really happy with this. So one lunchtime, I just decided to walk to the pier. It's only about 10 minutes from my office. So this is the Kowloon side of things. And you can see the big buildings like the ICC. I'm not sure what all the different building names are. This is the new M Plus Museum. And I guess I simplified a lot of forms. I combined a lot of forms together. And these are supposed to be trees. And it was a really good clear day. So I tried to get in like the reflections in as well. Some of the signs here. There were some boats that were passing by. I couldn't get their full form. So I just tried to get that in real quick just because I thought the water was a little bit empty if I kept that out. And this is the same running spot I got. So it's actually pretty cool to see how much I've grown since sketching it the first time. This is November 19th. This is January 21st. And you can see just how differently I take in the forms. Tried to do in a little bit of these double lighting shadows. But here I stuck to a more simpler theme. So if you can see, it's basically the same kind of walls, the same kind of trees. But I just approach it really, really, really differently, even though it's the same subject matter. This is yet another taxi in front of a traditional medicine place. It was closed that day, so. These are sauce dispensers in IKEA. So there's some lingonberry, some mustard, some tomato sauces. This is in a rooftop near my office. If you want to see how I sketched this, I did post a video and I describe how I sort of captured this place together. But this is quite fun to do. It's my first time filming how I sketch on site, and I did find it a bit challenging. This was during a sunset. The sun was getting quite low. It made the shadows really long, and this is such a beautiful moment, so I had to like take out my sketchbook, start doing this really quickly. So there are like bicycles and there's a tree, and that's all it to it really, but I just really like the simplicity of the shadows over here. This is the last sketch, and of course it's an MTR sketch. This is a family of four heading somewhere for New Year's because everyone was wearing red that day and they were carrying bags, and usually people do bring gifts, especially during New Year. And that day everyone was bringing gifts on the train. This whole family was sort of sleeping. And yeah, that is my sketchbook tour. Hope you liked it. If you want to see more of this, please let me know in the comments. If you do have a sketching habit as well, please let me know what you use and how you use them. I would really love to see your drawings as well and to make new friends here in the art community on YouTube and on the internet. And I will catch you in the next sketching video. Bye!